We're given f of x and asked to find f prime of x and f prime of 4. And notice the given function f of x is a quotient, so to find the derivative function, we will have to apply the quotient rule stated here below, where the derivative of function f divided by function g with respect to x is equal to g times f prime minus f times g prime divided by g squared. Before we apply the quotient rule though, we do want to rewrite these square roots as rational exponents. And since for a square root the index is 2, and since we have the square root of x, this would be x to the first, the square root of x is equal to x to the 1/2 using this property here. So the given function f of x can be written as 2 times x to the 1/2 power minus 1 divided by 2x to the 1/2 plus 1. And now when applying the quotient rule, notice that our function f, the numerator would be 2x to the 1/2 minus 1, and the denominator, or g, would be 2x to the 1/2 plus 1. So f prime of x will be equal to the denominator, which is 2x to the 1/2 plus 1, times the derivative of the numerator, the derivative of 2x to the 1/2 minus 1, and then minus the numerator, 2x to the 1/2 minus 1, times the derivative of the denominator, the derivative of 2x to the 1/2 plus 1. All over the denominator squared, which should be 2x to the 1/2 plus 1 squared. So now we'll find the derivative here, and then simplify. So f prime of x is equal to, well, the denominator is going to stay the same for right now. So we have the quantity 2x to the 1/2 plus 1 times the derivative of 2x to the 1/2 minus 1. The derivative of 2 times x to the 1/2, we'd multiply by 1/2, 2 times 1/2 is 1, and then subtract 1 from the exponent. 1/2 minus 1 is negative 1/2. So this would be x to the negative 1/2, and the derivative of a constant would be 0. So then we just have minus the quantity 2x to the 1/2 minus 1 times the derivative of 2x to the 1/2 plus 1. Again, if we multiply by 1/2, that would give us 1, subtract 1 from the exponent. Once again, we have x to the power of negative 1/2. And again, the derivative of a constant is 0. So now we'll distribute the x to the negative 1/2 here as well as here. When we multiply 2x to the 1/2 times x to the negative 1/2, because the bases are the same, we add the exponents. That would be x to the 0, which is equal to 1. So that just gives us 2. And then we have plus, this would be x to the power of negative 1/2. And then we have minus, the same thing here. We multiply 2x to the 1/2 times x to the negative 1/2. That'd be 2x to the 0, or just 2. And then we have minus x to the negative 1/2. Let's go ahead and simplify this. Notice how these 2's would simplify out. 2 minus 2 would be 0. And then we have minus a negative, which becomes plus. So the numerator becomes just 2 x to the negative 1/2. And then we have divided by 2x to the 1/2 plus 1 squared. Let's go ahead and write this using radicals though. X to the negative 1/2 is the same as 1 over x to the 1/2, which would be the same as 1 over the square root of x. So this would be 2 divided by the square root of x divided by, again, x to the 1/2 would just be the square root of x. So we have 2 times the square root of x plus 1 squared. So this would be our derivative function. And now that we have the derivative function, we can determine f prime of 4. But before we do that, let's just make sure I didn't lose anybody here in the numerator. If we have 2x to the power of negative 1/2, We can write that as 2 divided by x to the 1/2. If you move this to the denominator, it changes the sign of the exponent. X to the 1/2 is the same as the square root of x. Now let's go ahead and evaluate this at x equals 4. So if we substitute 4 for x, we would have 2 divided by the square root of 4 divided by the quantity 2 times the square root of 4 plus 1 squared. Well, we know the square root of 4 is equal to 2, so the numerator simplifies to 2 over 2, or just 1. Our denominator would be 2 times 2, that's 4 plus 1, so we'd have 5 squared, so it's equal to 1/25. So f prime of 4 is equal to 1/25, which means if we graph the original function at x equals 4, the slope of the tangent line would be 1/25. Let's take a look at this. Here's the graph of our function. Here's the point on the function when x equals 4. And since f prime of 4 equals 1/25, the slope of this tangent line is 1/25. I hope you found this helpful.